Hello, if you've been lucky enough to stumble across this plumberparts.co.uk video about combination valves on unvented hot water systems, then great, we're going to have a look at that in any minute now. Please do subscribe to our videos by clicking on the card that's appearing right now. We do loads of videos on plumbing stuff, and also we do plumbing disaster photos and videos that you guys send in to us on a daily basis. Anyway, I hope you enjoy the video, and remember everyone, to hold tight! plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice. So this is just a really quick video to tell you about what combination valves do, how they work, and their basic use on an unvented system. We've got one here that, as you can see, is leaking from the pressure regulator top spring on here. And basically what we're going to do now is just swap that over for a new one in a second. But before we do that, I'm just going to show you how they work and the basic principle of what they do. So coming in at the top here, we've got mains cold water coming in at mains pressure, whatever that may be. Now remember that the mains pressure can fluctuate up and down according to what time of day it is. Generally it goes up at night because obviously less people are using the water, and obviously during the day it goes down a little bit. So we want to protect our whole hot water system and our tank here from getting so overpressurized that it bursts, especially if you live in a mains water area where the pressure can get over like 7 bar at night. That's way too much for these beasts. So the first principal thing that a combination valve does is regulates the amount of pressure that's going into the system. And if you look on the end here, you'll see that it says 3 bar on this. So we know now that the pressure going into the system is 3 bar. So another thing they can do that's really good is you can remove this nipple here, unscrew that plastic bung, and then screw a pressure gauge in so you can see what the pressure is coming into your system. So that's really handy. And then the next thing they can do on the way a bit down here, we have a 8 bar pressure relief valve. Obviously it's pretty self-explanatory what they do. If the pressure goes over 8 bar in the system, i.e. this fails, that pressure relief valve is going to start dumping water into this tundish here and then running away outside. The system that this combination valve is fitted on at the moment is a mega flow, so they've got their air pocket and their expansion in the top of the tank itself. But a lot of other unvented tanks have the expansion vessel remotely fitted, just like you would do on any corner heating system with a braided hose, and that is always fitted on this piece here. You can whip this out, pop a braided hose in, and then have your expansion vessel, which is kind of a big white bulbous thing, hanging next to it. Obviously the expansion vessel takes up expansion as well, but also I like to see it as a like a mini accumulator as well. Gives the system a little bit of a boost, a couple of litres of water when you open up that hot tap. One last thing they do as well, and it depends on the actual combination valve you've got, you can pipe it up on here, but you can have a balanced cold water out. So say you've got thermostatic mixer valves like on a shower, and it wasn't balanced, you might have some slight variation in the pressures on the hot and the cold side. If you pipe up the cold off the back end of the combination valve here and the hot as well, then that'll make sure that the pressures are both 3 bar and equal, and you won't have that problem. So to recap, the principal use of a combination valve is to regulate the pressure going into your hot water system. It's also to provide a safety drop off for high pressure should the combination valve fail. It also allows you the manifold to attach an expansion vessel to the system, and also it allows you to have a balanced cold feed out to anywhere else on the system, especially if you've got thermostatic mixer valves that rely on the hot and cold being of equal pressures. So that's enough of my babbling. I'm just going to whip this one out now. The new one we've got is slightly different, so it needs a little bit of work done to it. Like, we've got to put a bung in the back here, but it's really, really easy to do, and we're just going to do that now for you, and I hope you enjoy the beast. So you've seen very simply how you can remove one of these valves and pop a new one in, but this video would not be complete if we didn't have a sound idea and knowledge about how these valves actually work, how they actually take a high pressure cold water main feed on the other side and not only reduce that pressure to 3 bar, but maintain that throughout its use when everything else is open. So we've got the old valve here that we took out, and we're just going to take this apart and also draw you a nice little diagram to show you how these actually work. So the first thing we're going to do is just going to unscrew this piece here, and that will basically just come off like that. So basically this is the housing, quite obviously, for the spring underneath. Now the spring underneath then can act up and down, as you can see, on this small bellows here. Now the bellows are pushing back at the moment because there's a small bit of air pressure in there. Now the best way to see this is this spring is only going to push down if the pressure on the outlet off to your taps is below 3 bar, and we'll show you now how the pressure on the other side works. So we'll unscrew this small screw here. So we've got a metal plate on the outer part here that holds our rubber bellows down. We've also got a small metal plate on the inside that ensures when this nut is on top of it, that if the bellows should move up and down in any way whatsoever, the valve shaft, which is just here, this piece here is the valve shaft, will be able to move up and down with it. That's really important when it comes to automating the closing and opening of this valve. So there's our rubber bellows. We call these a bellows because they actually have to contract and expand according to the pressures on either side. So obviously we've got our spring pushing down on it, but we've got pressure that in a minute we're going to show you how that is pushed up. I'll put that out of the way. Now, if you look very carefully, this is really important as a whole part. Firstly, if I grab this with a set of grips, we should be able to move this up and down like that. I want you to take particular notice, there's a very small hole just down here. Just here, can you see there's a very, very small hole? That's really important to the operation of a combination valve and a pressure reducing valve. So you'll be like, this is great, you know, you've ripped this beast apart. We've got all these little bits here together. So how do they actually all go together to work? Well, let's have a look at this little drawing now. I'm going to show you the operation of it when it's demanding pressure and also the operation when it's up to pressure and it doesn't want to let any more pressure through. So let's say our water is coming in here at the moment at, say, 7 bar. We want to have about water coming out of this part here at 3 bar, at a constant nice flow as well. So this can be regulated up and down automatically. And at the same time, if this gets shut off, this is going to stop straight away, but only when this is set to 3 bar here. We've got this piece here. This is our cap, like you've seen earlier on. So there's our cap on there like that. And then we've got our shaft here with the little screw bit at the top like so. It's that little bit there on that like that. So let's have a look at how this is going to work. As you can see, at the moment, this is in the open operation. We've got our valve here. There's going to be like a little piece of rubber on here. And when this is closed, this is going to be lifted up and it's going to make a seat, a closed seat on these two points here. But at the moment, we're looking at it in the open operation. That means that this spring here, that if you remember, will sit about there like so, is going to be pushing down. Now we need to remember there has to be a way for this shaft to be lifted up and down, up and down. And that will only work if we have a fixed point on the shaft. So let's just say our fixed point is here. When we look at the shaft later on, we know that our fixed point is created by the small nut and the little plate that we've got on here like so. So at the moment, the water pressure on this side is we're calling for water here and the pressure here is a lot lower than the 3 bar that we've set at with this lovely little spring here. So at the moment, the spring is working down and pushing down like so. But I mean, you probably say, well, the spring's there the whole time. How does it know when to push down? Well, that's when the rubber bellows and the very small hole that we showed you about earlier on comes into play. So if we look here, we've got a plastic area just here, and underneath that's a rubber seat. This piece does not move, and it's completely sealed off, water-wise and pressure-wise, from what's going on underneath here. Our plastic piece is just gonna sit under there like so, like that. There's no way with this plastic piece sitting here that any pressure whatsoever from here can get into there. There's no leak of pressure up there, only what we want to leak. So at the moment, like we say, we've got our spring pushing down like this, and we're saying, well, what's going to regulate when this spring is going to be pushed back up? We've got our small bellows. Let's just say our bellows at the moment is here. Okay, so our bellows is in that push-down position. Now, the reason it's in that push-down position is very simple. That small hole we saw is just there like so, okay? And there's a small hole that drills down through the shaft to here. So when the pressure on this side goes down, the pressure inside here that's linked to these two holes here will also go down. The bellows will push down because the spring is pushing on it, and therefore the valve will push down and start letting water into the system, okay? So we've got 7 bar, and that'll only ever happen when this drops below 3 bar here. So let's use the blue pen now to show you what it'll be like when it's in closed operation. So say we've shut the tap here, and bang, it goes up to 3 bar. This is going to happen, the whole thing I'm about to describe now is going to happen within fractions of a second. Firstly, the pressure on this side is going to go up, okay? Which means the pressure going into that small hole there and coming out of the small hole just up here is also going to go up. Now, you guys guessed it already. That means the bellows pressure is going to act on our fixed point here, which on the other side has our spring. It's going to contract our spring upwards like so. And then our bellows, obviously, is going to push on our fixed point, which our fixed point will end up here. Our bellows are going to end up like that. And guess what? Because it's pushed on the fixed point of the shaft, the valve seat is going to come up like this. And then bang, that's shut off. That's how an automated one of these works. Let's say you open up the tap a little bit. The taps just open a slight amount. The pressure in here is going to slightly go down. Maybe there'll be a sort of more of a balance pressure between what's under the bellows and the actual pressure exerted by the spring, which means that also the valve is going to open a little bit and let a little bit of water through. Another thing you need to think about with these as well is sometimes they do actually require a service. It's quite difficult to see, but inside here you do have a gauze, and that's just protecting the main kind of valve body on each side from getting any muck in it and all that. But as you can see, that's failed on this one here. So there you go, you've now seen how a combination valve works on an unvented hot water system, how it regulates the pressure, what it does, and basically the principles behind the whole thing. I hope you found this video helpful and informative, and if it hasn't, then by all means, comment in the comments section below, share the video with your friends, and as ever, follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Anyway, thanks ever so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in our next video. Remember, everyone, to hold tight. See ya. Plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice.